And we're back talking about the after effects from the debate last night in the Senate. We've got Eric Eisnaugle, Republican, Democrats got Randolph. And Eric, you wanted to finish up a thought before we went to a break.
I really couldn't help it, Greg, and thanks for giving me a chance. You know, I need to address this whole notion that President Obama and the Democrats have somehow decreased taxes on the middle class. It's absolutely untrue. You know, Obamacare is a huge tax increase on the middle class and on everybody, really. And the Supreme Court has said so. I mean, Obama told us that it wasn't a tax increase. He told us that. And in fact, I don't think the bill would have passed had he called it a tax increase. Well, the U.S. Supreme Court has told us, indeed, it was a tax increase, and it was a massive one. You know, I mean, it's sort of similar to Obamacare, you know, also raiding Medicare, I mean, $700 billion, raid of Medicare. I mean, look, to say that the Democrats have lower taxes on the middle class just isn't accurate.
All right, we've steered the train away from the Senate debate. We're going to try to get it back on track. Talking about immigration, Bill Nelson voted for the DREAM Act. Mac did not. Mac says, I'm opposed to amnesty. Here's what else they said last night.
What you need is you've got 11 million people here. You've got to get them in a situation that if they're eligible to go to the back of the line, they have to pay a fine, they have to have a clean record, they have to learn English, and then they can apply.
We need to make sure that we secure our borders, both north and south. We need to make sure that we give our employers the tools they need with E-Verify to make sure people who are looking for work are legally allowed to get work.
A lot of people have talked about E-Verify. E-Verify, though, has been criticized for not being as accurate as it should.
I've run three amendments on E-Verify in the state legislature, and the Republican keeps blocking them.
Well,
the majority keeps blocking them in Florida.
Like, and the argument has consistently been that it is not a reliable system. Is it a reliable system?
It is 99.5%.
They say one out of five times it's a bad hit.
And when it is a bad hit, it's quickly resolved. But it's 99.5% accurate. And by the way, again, I filed three amendments to try to put E-Verify in, and I always was blocked by the Republican majority. But in Congress, one of the Obama, and by executive order, now required immediately coming into office that federal contractors use E-Verify. So federal contractors have been using E-Verify for the last 3 years under that Obama administration. By the way, and then Rick Scott did that. I would say Governor Scott did that when he came in for state contractors. So state contractors and federal contractors are using the E-Verify system.
All right. And this is one
30
area,
seconds you got.
This
Go
is
ahead.
One area where Scott and I can agree, and I'm proud to say that. Look, E-Verify is effective, and that's why I voted for it and I supported it. On the amendments that Representative Randolph offered, I mean, you know, I got to tell you, Greg, while he says they were in favor of E-Verify, they were really poison pills. And I think our viewers at home know what poison pills are, trying to actually kill the bill through an amendment that looks friendly but really isn't. I really support E-Verify, and that's why I voted in favor of the E-Verify bill in the Florida House to move it forward. I think that, you know, Connie Mack had a really good answer on this issue. I think it was where the mainstream Florida is, and that's why I think he scored points.
Okay. I think we're going to have to leave it at that for now. I'm sure you two will continue to discuss things as we send it on back to Meredith.